So welcome back, aliens. This is Navin Reddy from Talisker Learning. In this video, we'll talk about how Servlet works. So just imagine we have a client machine there and we have a server, right? So when you talk about this website world or this web world, so a client sends the request to the server expecting a page, right? Again, you can ask for anything on the internet, but let's say you're asking for a page now. Now this page can be a static page. It can be a dynamic page. When you say static, it means it is already made. And when you say dynamic, it means it will be built at runtime. So let's say a client sends the request, which is a static request. So it goes to a server. On your server, you already have a file, right? So that file goes to the client. Request done. And so we got the request and response. Finished, right? But let's say if you're asking for a page which is different, which is from the which will be built at runtime. So a client sends the request to the server. Now server says, hold on, I don't have any page with this link. So you have to make that page, right? And you have to build that page. So that request goes to a helper application. Can you see that? We got a helper application on the server. Now this helper application is also called as web container, okay? So in this web container, you'll be having servlets. Now what is servlet? So servlet is basically a Java file which can take the request from the client on the internet and it can process that request. It can provide you a response in the format of HTML page, right? So this servlet will convert your request and it will take your request, it will fetch the values, it will process the information and it will send the HTML page. Right, so let me just go back once again. So from client side, request goes to server. On the server side, since it is a dynamic request, it will go to your web container, which is, so what type of web container we have? So we have Tomcat, we can also use Glassfish, we can use JBoss, we can use WebSphere. In fact, all these other servers, those are called as app servers, but they also have a feature of web server. So basically, we always use Tomcat. In fact, in my subsequent videos, you will find all the things using Tomcat, right? So that Tomcat is a web container. So on your server, if you want to achieve the dynamic web pages, you need to install Tomcat, okay? So you can see that is Tomcat there. So that web container is a Tomcat. So when request goes to your Tomcat, Tomcat says, hold on, I got a request now, but that request is for abc.htm. And we don't have any page as abc.htm, right? So we have to build that page. So that request goes to a servlet. Hold on. Servlet will be having a Java name, right? Example, when you create Java classes, let's say I want to add two numbers. Again, a basic example. If I want to add two numbers, I will be having the servlet name as add servlet. That means when a request for abc.htm, the page which should be getting called is your servlet. How can we do that? So what we have is inside your container, you have a special file which is called as deployment descriptor. And this is how it looks. So you have a file which is deployment descriptor in which you mention for which request which servlet should be called. Okay, so let's say in your Tomcat server, you have maybe 50 to 60 servlets. So every servlet will be mentioned. I mean, every request will be mapped with one servlet. It may happen that you have multiple requests trying to access the same servlet, right? Everything need to be configured in a file which is called as deployment descriptor, and the file name is web.xml. So this file here is your web.xml file. So let me repeat, when client sends a request, it goes to the server. Now server thinks, okay, this is a dynamic page. Let's send the request to the web container. Now web container will check, okay, this request will be mapped by this servlet that can be done with the help of web.xml file. So you can see in the web.xml file, we have two tags. We have servlet tag and we have servlet mapping tag. So in the servlet tag, you have to mention the class name. And in your servlet mapping tag, you have to mention the URL pattern. So for this URL, we need to call that particular servlet. But hold on, how do we get a servlet now? And that's very simple. You can see we have a file here. So this is your file structure. So when you want to create a servlet, it's a normal class, okay, which extends HTTP servlet. Since we want this servlet features, right, we cannot create normal Pojo, which is your normal class. We have to create a special class which extends HTTP servlet, because this HTTP servlet will provide you all the features which you need. Okay. Now, when I say all the features, it means it should be able to take request from the server. It should be processing the request and it should be sending the response. How it will be done, that we'll see in the next video. But it takes the request, it processes the information, and it will send the response. Now, that response will be in HTML format. Again, you can send the response in JSON format, a normal string. You can send the response in XML format. You can also send the response in the HTML format. Now, that HTML page, which is a dynamic page, goes from your server to your client machine in the format of response object, right? So now, we have one more thing, right? We have web.xml file here. Do we have a replacement for that? Because the problem is we are Java programmers, right? And we don't like XML. Okay, that's not the case. But let's say we try to avoid XML. Now, how do we avoid XML? So in this servlet 3.0, we got a new feature which is called as annotations. So we can use annotations on your servlet. So you don't have to use XML files or web.xml file. You can do your mapping using annotation. Again, how that is done, that we'll see in the subsequent tutorials. But this is how your servlet basically works with the Tomcat servers. Okay, so a quick recap, we have a client machine, request goes to server, from the server, request goes to your web container. Web container uses a file called as web.xml to detect which servlet to call, and it calls the servlet. That servlet will process the information and it will send the response to the client machine. That's how it works. In the next video, we'll talk about how exactly your web container searches for the servlet and how it gets loaded and the lifecycle of the servlet. So thank you so much and do subscribe for further videos.